Promoting innovation through partnerships was the theme of a recent event held by the United Nations Economic and Social Council that brought together the private and public sector.
Sustainable development demands innovation from within the United Nations and beyond our walls. I look forward to your ideas for exchanging information, expanding learning, and working for the greater good.
Philanthropists and corporate leaders were invited to discuss how best they can work with the UN system to achieve global development goals.
We need to be more innovative in all these aspects, in developing technology, in building partnerships, in mobilizing finance. And there are so many good examples of out there how it can be done. So let's inspire each other and let's work together and making it happen.
Two recent UNICEF partnerships with the private sector demonstrate the potential of both partnerships and innovative approaches in delivering results for children that no one party can achieve alone.
We've really been fortunate to work in this new partnership, this public-private partnership. We've been working for about the last 18 months with UNICEF, doing some really remarkable things in the world. And I think it's a really, really exciting time and place.
What we've done is that we've provided a technology platform that facilitates the connection between travelers and UNICEF, so that we try to make all travelers donors to provide micro donations when they purchase, in our case, travel online.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are facing a challenge.
The government of Denmark and UNICEF also co-hosted a partnership clinic to explore how innovation and technology can help break the barriers to access quality learning for the most disadvantaged.
There are 250 million children in the world today who get to about the age of grade 4 and they can't read or write. Now that's just a little snapshot of the learning crisis that I think we have globally across the world.
We scanned all the textbooks and the textbooks are loaded here. There's a small projector that runs on a battery. You've got two speakers here.
UNICEF showed its digital school in the box, currently being tested in Uganda, as one example of technological innovation in education, but also emphasized that innovative approaches to education that promote learning are even more important.
I want to see that every moment that this child is in school or is in the community, there is an opportunity so that they can learn. So we are talking not about just about an education system that operates in a school. We are talking about a learning environment so that there is a whole environment in which child can learn.
Is it about technology? I can also agree it's not about technology either. It is about, when all comes to all, it's about the teacher. It's about the person standing in the room and meeting these kids.
And making sure that the children with the greatest needs are included.
The thing that I have in my mind the whole time is that girl in Ethiopia who has less than $2 spent on her in terms of her education per year. And I want to make sure that any ideas that we have can reach her and can give her a better life in terms of her education opportunities.
By partnering with the private and public sector, UNICEF is committed to leveraging technology and innovative approaches to increase access to quality education and learning to all children around the world. This is Bob Cohen reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org.